3, 2, 1. Hey, welcome back, welcome back. We are here at African American Youth Harvest Foundation with another special guest. What's your name?
Nadia.
Oh, did I say it right?
Say no, it's Nalia.
Nalia. I'm sorry, I messed up. My apologies. And a young lady by the name of?
Nina.
Miss Nina. Okay, cool, cool. Now, why do you like coming up here?
I like coming up here because I'm a single mom and I'm trying to raise African-American boys. It has been an area for them to be able to grow. They've been able to be around other peers that possibly come from the same home as them or another troubled home. My kids have been through a lot, so I feel like this is the best place for them to get a positive role model and not just somebody that's like, hey, go to work every single day. Hey, go out here and do that. They actually inspire them, so that's why I continuously bring them up here. Don't allow your past to define you, no matter what you've been through in your life. Somebody else has been through either the same thing or a little bit worse, so don't allow it to define you. I guarantee I don't look like I've been through what I've been through, and as long as you continue to put your best foot forward, no matter how many times you fall down, you're going to always get back up and go 5 more steps.
Oh, thanks. I like that. We're going to close it out like that. Thank you so much, young lady.
You're welcome. Thank you for having us.
Welcome back to African American Youth Harvest Foundation with your host for the night, Mr. Corey H. But I'm here with a special guest by the name of
Jesse Webb.
Now, why do you like coming up here, man?
It's always an honor to give back to the youth, to be a force in the community, especially in our community. I think there's never enough help, so giving any type of help or any kind of help is always a big help.
I like that, man. So, hey, appreciate it. Now, give me 10 seconds of a positive message that you want to give to the youth.
No matter what your past was, always look to your future. You can't change anything behind you, but you can always move forward to make it better.
I like that. Appreciate you, brother.
Yes, sir.
Man, you know, welcome back to African American Youth Harvest Foundation. But I'm here with a young lady by the name of
Ashley Miller.
Miss Ashley Miller, you've been coming up here. Now, why do you come up here so many times?
Because I bring my children. One is 16, one is 11.
Okay.
16 girl, 11 boy. For the mentorship, so they can have that foundation that I can't give them 24/7. I need that extra village, and the African American Youth Foundation gives me that village.
Definitely want you to leave the viewers or the youngsters with a powerful message. Give me 10 seconds of something inspirational for them.
Go for it. Anything and everything that you're capable of, you are capable of. Don't never let your skin color or your circumstances stop you from doing anything and everything you want to do. My two kids, we are a homeschooling family. Push them to strive for greatness by any means necessary, and they're capable of doing anything they want to do. My message to the youth today is dig into financial literacy. Don't let no one stop you from reaching your goals.
There you go. Hey, I appreciate you.
All right.
The special guest, a young lady by the name of
LaShonda. Shonda, y'all know who it is.
Miss LaShonda. Miss LaShonda, why do you come up here and why do you bring your children up here?
Well, I bring my daughter Lovely up here because, you know, Mr. and Mrs. Lofton, they are doing really good things for the community. Mentoring, they have things for little young boys. They even have a whole male health clinic. If you don't have insurance, come on up here. They give me that. They hooking me up. Like, my daughter having a school program, summer camp. They
hooking
me up. They
paying
me that.
Well,
yeah.
Hey, that's live, though.
Yeah.
Yes, this young lady was here during the spring break learning how to behind the camera. Matter of fact, let me ask you, what all did you learn?
I learned how to work a camera, how to talk in a microphone,
okay.
How to learn new things, and how to learn how to fly a drone.
And my apologies, I didn't even ask you. Can you please let them know who you are? What's your name?
My name is Lovely.
Yeah, you fancy, sir. Why do you come here?
I come here to learn new things at the girls' mentoring. My mom signed me up to learn new things, how to take care of one each other, how to make new friends, and learn how to respect each other.
Can you give me 10 seconds of an inspirational quote that you would like to give to the youth? Something positive.
Be kind and try new things because you don't know who you're going to meet out there, and they might be the person you need inside your heart.
Greetings. I'm Michael Lofton, founder and executive director for the African American Youth Harvest Foundation. I'm here with none other than brother Mr. Don Hyder. How you doing today, sir?
I'm doing just fine.
Good to see you.
I'm
good
doing
to see
just
you.
Fine.
To talk to the community a little bit, Mr. Hyder is a barber. Tell the community a little bit about your barbershop and how long you've been in business.
14 years, but I've been doing this about 16 years, 2 years prior.
working, you know, just a contract as a barber. Then I got my own barber shop 2 years later, and I had been there all the way up to this point.
Yeah. The reason why we have him today, he is going to be the new barber here in the house at the African American Youth Harvest Foundation. So we were telling all of our families, you got kids, bring them on up here. Tell them, for folks that may want to reach out to you, call you, how can they contact you? Can you give them a contact number?
Yes, I can. You can reach me at area code 512-905-7533. And the name is Don Hyder. You can also reach me at Google Hyder Hair Depot Barbershop. And you can also book online also.
All right. So your passion for working with youth, how did you come to, you know, saying that, hey, this is really what I want to do?
Well, the first thing that catches my attention about kids is because I'm a father slash grandfather in real life. I have a passion for the kids because I love kids. I was raised that you shouldn't create a stumble for the kids spiritually, and I'm the same way when I give haircuts. When they sit down in the car, I want them to get a haircut, I want them to have the best cut they have.